Hey everybody, it's Brian Loans from the NHRA on Fox, and you know, we're halfway through the regular season, which sounds insane, but that's the facts. I want to catch up with a guy who's currently sitting third in the Nitro Funny Car points at this point in that first half of the season. His name's Ron Capps, driving the Napa GR Supra. How you doing, Ron?
I'm good. How you doing, Brian?
I'm doing well. And Ron, I wanted to catch up with you because, you know, we've seen so much action in the funny car category. You've been in the thick of a lot of it. And I want to kind of get your personal evaluation of how you think the first half of this regular season has gone for the Napa team.
Well, it's funny for us. We just had this discussion. We got to kind of separate ours a little bit because we started with a Supra at the four wides at Z-Max. To win the championship and then go in as a new owner into this season, you know, you're thinking and hearing and reading about all these owners have talked about things in the past about how hard it was going to be. But we unloaded and went number one qualifier at the Winter Nationals and then almost won the race. We came within a few feet of winning. So it was like, oh, my gosh, I mean, how can we beat this weekend? So the progression's been great. And we were just waiting for that Supra body to put on there and see what we could do. And it's got so much potential. The fact we unloaded there and went 388, I think it was, the very first run ever. But basically, our season kind of had to start over there. But leading up to there, I would give it an A-. You know, Guido and Medellin and the guys are just consistent. And I've been very blessed to have that kind of race car underneath me for a long time. And that's what won us the championship, honestly. So, you know, since then, we're kind of filling out this car. The body is definitely different. Aerodynamically wise, it's gotten Guido and those guys, it's a thoroughbred that wants to run, and we just kind of have to get used to it. So I would say since Charlotte, we're about a B+, but we're kind of hanging in there.
Yeah, that's a very interesting thing to think about. You know, when fans at home see a new body get plunked on top of a chassis, obviously the car looks different, but the reality is the aerodynamic forces acting on these cars at 300-plus miles an hour, it changes a lot. I mean, that what we call the center of pressure, where the force of the air is actually forcing the body down, and you have to adjust the tune-up for the body. It's kind of an invisible deal that I know John Medellin and Guido are working hard to figure out. And listen, they don't seem too far behind it.
To not know where anything was, to go off of what we've had for a year and a half of running great, winning a championship with what we ran before, and to hit it like that and go the next run, go 330 miles per hour. It was a tribute to the help we got, obviously, from the DHL and Del Worsham and Alexis's team. And then Slugger, Labby, who has worked his tail off Toyota-wise. The guys right now as we speak are mounting a little different and working on little things here and there, and just it's constant.
You know, we talk about the team aspect of this sport, and what we have seen so far is not too much of a surprise, but I think it's really starting to show itself now in the fact that the teams that maintain their stability in terms of employees, in terms of crew guys, in terms of their just overall workflow are the ones that have succeeded in this first half of the season. So how does that play out in your mind? I mean, it's not like you have anybody learning new roles, and I think that only gets better as the season goes on.
Yeah, really, the only person that had to learn new roles was me, pretty much. You know, I thought about this the other day. I've had my best success in my career when I show up and walk in the pit area, and my goal is to impress and do the best I can to make my crew chief and my crew members proud. And so it's been crucial for me to keep that mentality and not just the team owner role, and to try to separate that. And it's not been easy. I mean, those guys are right that have talked about it, Wilkerson and Cruz and Forrest and all them that go down that, and Antron. So it is a constant battle. But when I show up and I'm just thinking, how am I going to do the best I can do? And I've done it over my career with Roland and Ace and Ron Tobler. And that's the best day for me. When I grab my backpack and I leave the pit area at night after shaking hands and signing autographs and I get in the rental car, when I can go, you know what, I think I did the best that I could do, and I made Guido and Medellin as proud as I could make them at what I did. Maybe they didn't say anything, which is a good thing. That means I did everything right. But that, I think, has been the best probably success for me, and I feel like we've had that again this year. And if I can keep that up, I'll be okay in the seat.
The Winging It with Ron Torch, I've been more than happy to crash a couple of the last couple of those. We're with Bentley Warren up in Maine, having a riot. And, you know, this thing has really kind of started to take on a life of its own, which I know was the intention of it when you got the season going. But when I was leaving Bentley's to go back to the racetrack, there was a lot of fans coming in to hang out there. And I think this thing's really gaining some steam.
Breaking news here, but we're going to have another fun one come up prior to Bristol with you and I and the Fox people. So I'm looking forward to that because we have a very special guest who is going to fit right in with what we've been doing. So it's just been fun. It's fun. I've learned a bunch. The one that is about to come out from you and I still can't believe you did what you did, and I applaud you, but holy smokes, man, that was crazy.
The fix was in on this, and we're not going to give away the surprise, but let's just say I got mine, and then that's all we're going to say about that. So last question here, Ron. We're heading to Bristol and Norwalk back-to-back. I know as a guy in my position, I really like when we get into these back-to-back scenarios. I feel like it builds momentum for our season, builds momentum for our storylines. The Bristol racetrack is being ground like as we speak. They're working on it right now to smooth out a couple of the bumps there, which is cool. But this is almost unheard of. To have a racetrack being kind of ground or touched up this close to a race is going to add a whole new element.
Well, it's happened a lot in the past, but I got to give you a little bit of my breaking news, I guess. I was there yesterday, flew there on my way home, and Kurt Johnson, track fixer extraordinaire, was there to grind it. And the track had already had people come in, and they did everything they could to raise up those areas that had sunk a little bit. And you got to remember this. It was because a lot of the reasons were that access that fans have across the grandstands to get right into the area was that tunnel. So it created a little bit of havoc with the track. They fixed most of it.
Well, it's going to be you and a whole field of others down there at Bristol, Tennessee, one of the coolest drag strips on planet Earth. Ron, thanks for taking the time today. Can't wait to see you down there on the Thursday before the race. And going to be another good time, certainly before the race and during it. The racetrack, as you said, they've elevated some of those concrete pads. They got Kurt down there touching it up. Can't wait to get to Thunder Valley, baby. It's the only place like it on the planet. He's Ron Capps, I'm Brian Lones, and both of us will be at the NHRA Thunder Valley Nationals coming up this coming weekend. It is going to be absolutely spectacular, and you can get your tickets on NHRA.com. Grab your seats, because this is a once-in-a-lifetime place. If you've never been to Thunder Valley, the noise, the sound, the echoes, unparalleled. Thanks for watching. We'll be back soon.